Belinda Audiobooks presents this unabridged recording of The Gizmo, written by Paul Jennings and read by Francis Greenslade. Be sure to visit our website on www.belinda.com. Details of other available and forthcoming Belinda Audiobook releases can be found at the end of this recording. Chapter 1. I've never stolen anything before. That's why I'm not feeling so good. I think I'm going to be sick all over the stall. I look at the electric gizmos all laid out for people to buy. What if I spew up just as I'm taking something? What if I vomit right when I lean over the counter? Everyone in the market will look. The police will grab me. They'll tell my father. It'll be in the papers. Everyone will know about the boy who was sick when he was trying to nick.
Go on, says Flogget. Don't be a wimp.
He is standing there in his stolen leather jacket and stolen jeans. He's pointing at one of the gizmos.
Quick, knock it off, he says.
Why did I agree to this? Why?
You promised,
says Flogget. He holds up the spanner that he stole from the lady on the tool stall.
You promised to nick something if I did.
I did promise too. But I was just showing off, pretending to be tough. What an idiot. I don't want to take anything. But I promised. And Flogget will tell the kids at school that I wimped out. Broke my word. I couldn't let that happen. No way. I swallow and try to hold down my dinner. I look at the little man who owns the stall. He's sort of strange. Like a man from another world. There's something not quite right about him. His eyes are wrong. When he blinks, you can see through them, as if they're windows. It seems to be raining inside his head. He looks as if he could snap his fingers and turn me into a worm. I'm scared of him. And I'm scared of Flogget. I'm too scared to steal something. I'm too scared not to. What will I do? The little man bends down to tie up his shoe. It is almost as if he is daring me to take something. Behind him, I see a sign that says, "Thieves will be punished."
Quick, whispers Flogget. This is your chance. Go, go, go!
It's now or never. I close my eyes and grab something from the counter. I don't even know what it is. I turn and run. I scamper off like a terrified rabbit. I hear Flogget's breath and pounding feet as he runs behind me. I run and run until my heart hurts so much that I have to stop. I collapse into a heap behind the hot dog stall. I wait for the screams and shouts. I wait for someone to yell, "Stop, thief!" But no one does.
"Hoo-wee!"
yells Flogget.
"You did it! You finally grew up!"
He pats me on the back.
"What a hero!"
he says. Flogget grins at me. He is glad that I have done what he has done.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.